The first time we ever heard of the Starship from Elon Musk's SpaceX was back in 2016. Since then, the world has been obsessed with it and always follows the news of its development. However, most uninformed people are really biased towards it. Therefore, it is good to listen to a professional's view on this while knowing where they stand. Join us today as we take a look at what scientists have to say about the Starship and Elon Musk's vision of starting a colony on Mars. Remember to leave a like on this video, subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos, and hit the bell icon for notifications on new videos. And with that said, enjoy the video. SpaceX has basically taken over the space industry. They have made so much unmatched progress that they are now at the top of the list. After SpaceX started shaking up the space industry, NASA warmed up to the Texas-based company. Not only NASA, but also its scientists. According to Ars Technica, Jennifer Heldman, NASA research scientist, said, "You can really take advantage of Starship's architecture and get to the outer solar system in ways we haven't thought about before. It could provide a revolutionary new way of exploring these worlds." According to Heldman, the Starship's scale could actually be the breaking point in sending the first humans to Mars. Not only that, but it could also facilitate the sending of robotic research equipment to other planets and moons. This could help us explore more of the solar system. Heldman encouraged planetary scientists to start thinking of ways in which they can take advantage of the Starship because it is extraordinary. Back in 2018, SpaceX approached the planetary science community with a bunch of Mars workshops. The workshops addressed basic questions like the potential landing spots on the red planet. In addition, they addressed the knowledge that would be required to build a sustainable environment where people could safely live and work. Some great names from the Mars research community were invited to the workshop. Several of them had the opportunity to participate and say something during the workshop. In any group, there are always those who support and others who are against something. The same case goes for planetary scientists. There were those who supported SpaceX's vision, while others remained skeptical about it. However, this was when SpaceX was just starting the development of its rockets. As time went by and SpaceX started building and testing prototypes, some of the planetary scientists who were skeptical switched sides. Tanya Harrison, one of the planetary scientists and Mars experts who had the opportunity to participate in the workshop, said, "As Starship began to seem more real, it has changed people's minds. Starship being selected for the lunar missions was a huge credibility boost. Come early 2021, most of the workshop participants started to see the urgency of getting NASA on board with using Starship for science missions. They had to come up with a plan to convince NASA to do this. They came together and drafted a white paper titled Accelerating Martian and Lunar Science Through SpaceX Starship Missions. The lead author of this paper was none other than Heldman. Apart from Heldman, the paper was also signed by other Mars researchers from academia, SpaceX, and the space industry in general. The paper pushed NASA's leaders to consider and start providing funding for scientific payloads that could fly on the Starship. These scientific and engineers wrote, NASA must develop a funded program aligned with the development approach from Starship, including a rapid development schedule, relatively high risk tolerance compared to traditional planetary science missions, and ultimately a high ratio of potential science value for the dollars spent for its success. But what sets the Starship apart from all the other spacecrafts in existence? At the moment, it's mass. Till date, the two biggest issues that scientists have when planning space missions are cost and mass. SpaceX has found a way of dealing with both issues. Starship offers a lot more space for a lot less money. The greatest change is that scientists no longer have to be hyper-focused on mass. They now have the ability to carry even more instruments and more shielding. This, according to Harrison, changes the whole game. The author of the white paper deemed it important to highlight Starship's potential value, even though there was a lot of political pushback. According to the white paper, the development of the Starship is a golden opportunity for NASA to rethink how it has done exploration for more than half a century. Missing that would be a shame. The potential shown by SpaceX is like no other. It has never been seen across the generations, and the next planetary scientist, James Head, can confirm this. In the 1960s, James was part of the team selecting Apollo landing sites. In addition, he trained the astronauts landing there. Since then, he has had a distinguished planetary science career. While signing the white paper, he did so enthusiastically, saying that he appreciates that SpaceX has a compelling vision and is diligently working towards that goal. During his visit to SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California, he said that the youth, energy, and determination there is the same as the one that propelled the first moon landing. He said being on the floor at the SpaceX factory is the closest I've felt to having been in the Apollo program. Alongside being a British scientist, Brian Cox is also a bona fide global TV sensation. He has some interesting takes on SpaceX. Cox believes that soon people will start landing on Mars. He says it's possible that you could if you had the investment. I think we know how to do it, but I think it's likely to be more like 2 decades until mankind is on Mars. But you never know. It's been remarkable how fast SpaceX and Blue Origin are advancing. The biggest change over the last few years, according to Cox, is the development of reusable rockets. SpaceX has managed to build a rocket that you can fly into space and bring back to Earth in a reusable state. Cox said that these might be the rockets that will be used to carry astronauts, scientists, and anyone else willing to move from Earth. Cox introduced the Mars Direct Plan, which is a plan on how to move people from Earth to Mars. According to the plan, the supplies would be sent first. This means that the base would be sent first, and then, once the base is working, the people would be sent. This then becomes a permanent settlement, and it eventually grows. This does fall perfectly in line with Musk's plan for a colony on Mars. Musk is very ambitious about this, and knowing him, building a settlement on Mars is very much possible. In Brian Cox's new documentary, Adventures in Space and Time, Dr. Robert Zubrin, an American aerospace engineer, said that the idea of interplanetary travel is not beyond our technology. He said that a human mission to Mars wouldn't be venturing into new and unknown worlds of physics. We're talking about brass tacks engineering, building systems of moderate size and taking them there. We do not need giant Battlestar Galactica spaceships. Dr. Zubrin says that Elon Musk is some sort of gift to humanity. As he says, in the year 2000, we only heard of entrepreneurs who would make this happen on characters in science fiction stories. Now, such characters are no longer science fiction, but reality. In early 2021, Musk revealed SpaceX's plan to start a colony on Mars. According to his plan, they want to build a 1 million strong self-sufficient city by 2050. He plans to produce about 1,000 Starship aircraft and launch 3 per day. Each Starship would carry about 100 tons of equipment and 100 people. This is all in the hope of building a permanent settlement on Mars. Using SpaceX, Musk is slowly bringing the science fiction world into reality. Neil deGrasse Tyson, a celebrity astrophysicist, has also had some hot takes on Musk's companies. Even though he still criticizes the Mars mission, he has warmed up to Musk. Back in 2017, during an Ask Me Anything session on Reddit, someone asked him, "Just wanted to know your thoughts on SpaceX's Falcon 9 relaunch and landing. What do you think it means for the future of space travel?" Neil's answer to this was, "Any demonstration of rocket reusability is a good thing. Reusability is arguably the most fundamental feature of affordable, expensive things." The same Reddit user asked him whether he would consider joining a future one-way trip to Mars. His response was, "I really like Earth. So any space trip I take, I'm double-checking that there's sufficient funds for me to return. Also, I'm not taking that trip until Elon Musk sends his mother and brings her back alive. Then I'm good for it." That was kind of dark, even for him. But the idea is that he was not fully for SpaceX. However, as time passes, so do opinions. A year later, Neil turned out to be one of SpaceX's biggest fans. During an interview with CNBC Make It, Neil surprised the world when he said that Musk would transform civilization. He said that Elon Musk was going to have a bigger influence on society than other tech personalities like Jeff Bezos, Steve Jobs, and Mark Zuckerberg. Neil then goes on to say, "Musk is not simply giving us the next app that will be awesome on our smartphone. No, he is thinking about society, culture, how we interact, and what forces need to be in play to take civilization into the next century. Michio Kaku, an American theoretical physicist, has great respect for Musk and what he has done. On a Fox Business show, he says that Musk SpaceX is way ahead of Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin when it comes to space exploration. Michio says that it's not head-to-head like the media would like to portray, you know, the battle of the billionaires. SpaceX has a tremendous lead over Blue Origin. They've been around the Earth several times. They go to the space station. In fact, the last launch that they had even gone past the Hubble Space Telescope. That's how far it went into outer space. When Michio says something, you better pay attention because he does not joke around. SpaceX might just be able to start orbital test flights in 2022, which is already here, of the Starship as they build a highly reliable one. If you enjoyed the video, then remember to hit the thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button for more interesting videos. Until next time, bye.